You guys, what if I figured out what causes autism? Could autism be caused by something sneaky that has gone unnoticed but has been right under our noses? Let's get right into it. Is autism caused by vaccines?
No, in my opinion. My parents and my grandparents on both sides were never vaccinated, and I only had a couple of vaccines when I was older, around 7 years old. So, how could I be autistic? It was clear that I had ADHD and autism prior to that age. Doesn't add up. There may be a far sneakier culprit that has gone under the radar.
Call me crazy, but I think the real culprit is insulin resistance. Insulin is a hormone in your body created by the pancreas, and when it's impaired, the cells in your muscles, fat, and liver don't respond normally by using the glucose up in your body. Your pancreas gets confused and then pumps more insulin. That's why your blood sugar goes up. I'm sure that sounds odd. Okay, that's really, really odd. But insulin resistance is behind many disorders, such as diabetes, gestational diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, PCOS, Alzheimer's, dementia, and the list keeps growing, especially with cognitive disorders. Oh, and I forgot to mention, those infuriating skin tags? Yeah, you can thank insulin resistance for that. I found many studies and articles that support my theory. I've included PubMed's links on autistic individuals having brain insulin resistance and many other health problems. In doing a lot of new research about the connection between insulin resistance and autism, I found that the general public is actually glucose impaired and hyperinsulinemic. They even went so far as to mention why the ketogenic diet positively affects those with ASD and many of those other disorders. Definitely check out all those interesting links below. I should also mention that there could be other causes for autism, not just one, but this was just something that stood out the most to me. Speculated causes of autism, like having an immediate family member who is autistic, genetics, or being born by older parents, are not the true reason for autism. My theory is, it only seems that way. If a family becomes insulin resistant from external causes, their genes mutate or change, a process called epigenetics. But note that this can be reversed. If your family a few generations ago already started to have insulin resistance, the likelihood of it showing in a family down the line is probably what's really happening. This would then make sense of why it is predicted that 50% of individuals in the future will be diagnosed with autism. This doesn't explain why Asian cultures like the Japanese, who live on a high-carb diet, don't seem to be insulin resistant. This really depends if you're looking at Japanese Americans or Japanese people from Japan. I believe that if you walk or bike as much as Japanese people do in Japan, like 5 to 15 miles a day, you would utilize all that stored energy. Japanese Americans, however, have been shown to be more overweight and have more health problems. This is just purely my own speculation, but more and more studies are coming up with the same conclusion. So keep watching future videos to be up to date with scientific studies. Thanks for watching.